हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज हाइड्रोकोलेटरल यूनिट। हियर वी विल सी देर आर सम नॉब्स एंड लैंप्स अवेलेबल। दिस इज टू कंट्रोल द टेम्परेचर। हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज अ टेम्परेचर कंट्रोल नॉब। दिस इज स्विच टू टर्न इट टर्न द मशीन ऑन एंड ऑफ। दिस इज अ टेम्परेचर इंडिकेटर लाइट। This is the main indicator light. It will glow when you will switch it on, and whenever you are increasing the temperature, this will indicate that this machine is working properly. Now, as you can see, this is made up of metal. There is also a lead. So this is the lead. Here you can see inside. Here you can see from inside also it is made up of metal, but between those things there is an insulation to maintain the temperature. Whatever the inside temperature is there, it has to be maintained at proper temperature. So it will be maintained with the help of an insulation. Now below this you can see there is a coil. With the help of this coil, the temperature of the water increases. Here is a tap so that excess of the water or whatever, whenever you want to change the water. So, with the help of this tap, it will be changed or removed. So, this is the main coil. This coil gets heated up whenever you switch on the machine. This gets heated up, due to which water boils at particular temperature. We can maintain that the temperature of the water should be raised between 70 to 75 degrees Celsius. Now this is a tongs. With the help of the tongs you can pick up the hydrocollateral packs. Now the water is filled inside the hydrocollateral unit, and this can be placed or hooked on the hooks. As water boils and it is too hot, so you don't have to put your or dip your hand inside that, so that you get any type of burn. With the help of tong, you remove the collateral pack from the unit. Now these are the packs, hydrocollateral packs. It comes in shapes and sizes. As you can see here, these are the different shapes and sizes. This is mostly used for the cervical and upper back. This is a large size, can cover the large area like the pelvis, low back, upper back also you can, for the back also you can use this. This is a smaller size comparatively, so for smaller joint you can use this. Now here you can see that it is made up of a fabric. So yes, you can see it is made up of fabric. Inside there is a bentonite crystals. Now advantages of bentonite crystals are that it absorbs the heat. It absorbs the heat and it retains the heat inside it properly, so that you can apply those thing on the body for more time. Now this is a fabric pockets. These are the fabric pockets. Here you can see the advantages of fabric pockets are that whenever you are applying a hot pack on particular area, the bentonite crystal will not accumulate at particular region. The heat will be evenly distributed on each area. So each area the bentonite crystal will remain inside the fabric pockets, which again transfer the heat from this to the body area. And second benefit is that it can be mounted and you can apply it on any of the part. So there will be even heat, and this can be again placed it on the any of the area. So this is about the packs and the unit. While applying the hot pack, as you remove the excess of water using the tongs. You will remove the excess of water, then you will put this hot pack inside the towel. You will place inside the towel. There should be n number of layers, so you will adjust it according to the layers and you will put it inside. And now this pack will be applied on the body tissue. Now remember that whenever you want to increase the heat, then you decrease the layers of towels, and you want to, whenever you want to give more heat to the patient, then you decrease the layers. And advantages of using the towel is that it will absorb the excess of water which is inside the hot pack. Now about the application of the hydrocolloidal pack. Now, as I have already told you that the hydrocolloidal pack has to be placed inside the towel with different layers. Then if you are applying it on shoulder, first you have to check for the indications and you have to list out the contraindications. And as you are applying a hot pack, so you have to check for the thermal sensations, whether thermal sensations are proper or not, so that you can take the precaution, so that it should not cause burn to the patient. There should be no thermal injury. So after that, all those things you will again place the hot pack across the shoulder. You will apply it on the shoulder. So this is how you are going to place it on the shoulder. For upper back and neck. So this is the type of the hot pack which you are going to place it on the back. So I have already put it inside the hot pack, inside the towel, and you again check the indications, list out the contraindications, check the thermal sensation of the patient, and then you place it on the neck and the upper back. You again give the instructions to the patient whenever they are feeling too much of heat. The temperature of the body tissue should not be raised too much. Okay. For low back, again same, you will place it on the low back area.